How hard can it be to set up a Windows 10 virtual machine on Unraid, right? Welcome to the Hippie Geeks. Let's dig into this project. Our Unraid server needs a Windows 10 virtual machine installed so that we can set up our Amcrest NVR software to record the footage from our security cameras. This is the dashboard of our Unraid server. Before you can set up a virtual machine, there are a couple of things you will need to check. In the upper right of the screen, you will need to click on the computer icon, which will bring up your Unraid system info. The settings that you need to make sure are marked enabled are HVM and IOMMU, and if they are not, you will need to enable them in your motherboard's BIOS before going any further. Once those show up as enabled, you can close system info and move on to the next step. Click on Settings, and then click on VM Manager. You will need to change the Enable VMs dropdown to Yes, and then, where it lets you choose the default Windows VirtIO driver ISO, click on the one at the top of the list, and you should have the option to download it on the right. You can also see the option for PCIe ACS override. You may eventually need to change that from disabled to both, depending on what hardware you will eventually try to pass through to the virtual machine. Once you have set all of that, click on Done. Along the top bar, you should now be able to see the VM section, which means that everything is set properly. Instead of using the Unraid array for the boot drive and storage, we are going to pass through two of our unassigned drives to give it bare metal performance that isn't dependent on the array. To do that, open up a notepad and start by typing this out. /dev/disk/by-id/ata-. I am creating two of these entries as I will be passing through two drives. On the main page, go down to the unassigned devices section and highlight the entire name of the drive that you want to pass through. Copy that text by using Ctrl+C or right-clicking and hitting copy. Flip back over to the notepad and paste that directly after the ATA dash, which should look something like this. I am going to do the exact same thing with the other drive that I will pass through, so that I now have two lines that I will use in just a minute. On the top bar, click on the VM section that showed up in the last step. You are going to hit Add VM, then click on Windows 10, which will bring up the Add Windows 10 VM screen. First up, you will need to name it. I am going to use NVR just to keep it easy. Next up, you will need to assign some cores to the virtual machine. Avoid CPU 0/1, but other than that, I will typically give it two of the cores with their extra threads just for the setup, and then reduce it down once it is all set up. In this case, I used CPU 2/3 and 4/5. After that, it is time to assign the initial memory. In this case, I went with 4 gigs that will again be reduced once it is up and running. Next up, you have to choose machine type. The default setting is i440FX 4.2. However, I prefer to scroll down and use Q35 4.2, as it seems to be more compatible with a wider array of video cards if you decide to pass one through later. Leave the BIOS as OVMF in all but a couple of situations. If your VM refuses to start up with OVMF, then try it with CBIOS to see if that solves your problem. Leave the USB controller as 2.0, and then it is time to choose your OS install ISO. You will need to have a Windows 10 ISO file for this part. If you do not know how to get that downloaded, let me know in the comments below, and we will make a video detailing just how to find it and get it in the right place. I have two different ISOs in there, as I just downloaded the newest version, 1909, so I will be selecting that one. For the OS CD-ROM bus, select SATA, then move on to selecting your VirtIO driver's ISO. If you do not see the VirtIO-Win00.1.160-1 ISO, you probably forgot to download it in the earlier step when we were enabling the VMs, so check that out. Its CD-ROM bus needs to be SATA as well, and now it's finally time to pass through the hard drives that we decided on earlier. Flip over to the notepad and copy the first string of text, then go back to the VM setup. Change the primary VDisk location to manual, then on the right side, paste in the entire string of text. Make sure the primary VDisk bus is set to SATA and then hit the small green plus sign on the left to add another drive. Flip back over to the notepad and copy the second line of text and then add it just like you did the first one. Leave everything else the way that it is set and uncheck the box to start VM after creation. Hit create and wait for it to finish up. Once you are back at the VM screen, you can left click on the Windows icon to the left of the VM name and hit start. As soon as it is running, left click again and click on VNC remote, then as soon as the window comes up, hit any key. The whole process can get gummed up sometimes if you don't do it in that order with hitting the key, and if your Windows install isn't working, stop the VM, then start it again and try to get in quick enough to hit that key. Once it starts, this is now a basic Windows install. Select your language, hit next, and then click on Install Now. Click on I don't have a product key, then next, and then choose Windows 10 Pro, and next again. Accept the license terms, and on the next screen, click on Custom Install. As long as everything was passed through correctly, you should now see the hard drives that we selected. If they are not showing up, something did not get configured correctly, so go back through the steps and see what went wrong. Since I can see the drives, I'm going to install Windows on the 232GB SSD, as the 1863GB drive is our WD Purple surveillance drive that we want to record all of the security camera footage to. Once the drive is selected, hit next, and then just let Windows do its thing. For me, this initial setup took almost exactly 3 minutes before it was ready to restart and move on. There was then 2 minutes of getting ready with the black screen, before getting to the just a moment section for about another minute before it actually wanted some input from me. No, I do not want device activity history or help from the digital assistant. On the privacy settings, I select no for everything and then accept. About a minute and a half later, it will finally dump you into Windows. Right-click on the Windows icon in the lower left of the screen and select Device Manager. The first thing to update is the display driver. Even though it has one installed, there is a better one that we can use. Right-click on the Microsoft Basic Display Adapter and click on Update Driver. You want to click on Browse My Computer for Driver Software and then click Browse on the next screen. Scroll down to wherever the CD drive labeled vertio-win-0.1.1 is and click OK. In my case, that is drive E. When it finds the Red Hat driver, click on Install. Now that the display driver is out of the way, we are going to do the exact same thing for 3 of the 4 other missing device drivers, but first I need to change the mouse pointer as the base one is nearly invisible. Left click on the Windows icon in the lower left and start typing pointer. It will show change mouse pointer color, click on that, and then I like using the fully black mouse cursor. Now that I can see my cursor again, I moved on to the Ethernet controller. Hit browse, and the CD-ROM drive should still be selected, so hit OK. As soon as the driver is installed, Windows is going to want to bug you again, but just hit skip for now. Do the same thing for PCI device and for PCI simple communications controller. You can't do anything about the unknown device, so just ignore it. Now that all of your base drivers are installed, there is one more thing that we need to pull off of the VFIO disk. Open up Windows Explorer, click on the VFIO CD drive, go into Guest Agent, and install the x64 version. Feel free to start running Windows Update now to get the system completely set up. This gets you to the point of a fully functional Windows 10 virtual machine that can be used to run all kinds of things in the background on your Unraid server. We have one setup as a completely bare metal install with its own video card, hard drive, and USB controller that is run along 15-foot cables to our living room to be used as the main PC in there. This is a much smaller VM that we are going to set up as our security camera NVR and print server, but you are going to have to wait until the next video to see that, where we will go through all of the steps of setting up the Amcrest NVR software and getting everything hooked up so that we can scrub through the recorded footage from any other computer in the house. It is pretty sweet. If this is your first time here on the Hippie Geeks, it would be wonderful to have you subscribe. Hopefully, digging into this project with us will help you digging into your projects. If you enjoyed this video, give it a like and check out our Patreon page or merch store to support the channel directly. Thanks again, and we will see you on the next one.